Hi brothers and sisters, two videos in one day. This usually doesn't happen. However, I really feel the need to come on here because I know I'm not the only one getting really harsh backlash for believing in pre-trib rapture and called blasphemous against the Holy Spirit and stuff like that. But I just want to encourage you. Jesus says that you will know a tree by their fruit. So when you have people come on and say really nasty things to you because you believe something different than what they do, don't take it offense. Don't take offense to it. Just love them. There was a couple people on a channel that were not very nice in things that they post. And I went and posted some scripture. I'm on it. I am on it with the pre-trib scripture that the Lord has showed me because I used to be, I want to say mid or post-tribulation. I didn't really know that I believed in a rapture at all. I thought we'd have to get martyred and everything else until the Lord showed me last year that there is a pre-trib escape and opened my heart and showed me scripture. And still continues to reveal different scripture in the book. But one thing that I felt in the spirit as I was praying about this, because the Lord has just given me peace with conversations with these people. And they either have a veil over them or God has allowed them to be blinded over the pre-trib escape because the Lord is going to use them here in the end. And I know some people have been given the opportunity to stay or go because I've talked to some people who've the Lord has given them the opportunity to choose whether they want to go in the escape or stay back in tribulation. And I know that there's two people that said, so far from videos that I've watched, there's two people who said that they were going to stay back. And so I just want to encourage you because I know that these times are rough and I know that and I don't necessarily want to call them Pharisees. I think that maybe they're just blinded by the scripture and they don't believe. And so they are throwing rocks at us. They are like the Pharisees throwing rocks at people because we look at all the scripture. The Lord has opened our heart and our eyes to it and we see it and we're ready and we're trying to share it with the world. So we're going to have opposition of all kinds, even fellow brothers and sisters. The sad part is when you try saying, hey, it's okay. We don't believe the same. You know, one day I'll meet you in the presence of the Lord and, you know, and I'm just praying a blessing that God would watch over them and protect them during tribulation because I truly believe that if you don't believe in a pre-trib rapture and especially if you condemn and put our brothers and sisters down, you are not going to escape. You're going to be here. So I just prayed a blessing over them and pray that God uses them in tribulation and sends them to people who, their eyes will be open, of course, after the rapture, because they'll be like, oh, there was a pre-trib escape. But I pray that he uses them for people who are new believers and help them along their way. So they will be used, especially if they know their scripture well. The Lord will open their eyes and use them in tribulation to bring other brothers and sisters in Christ. That's why after the sixth seal, there's a multitude that nobody can even count of believers that come to heaven. So I just want to encourage you with that. If the Lord gives me any more, puts anything else on my heart, I'll be back to share it with you. But remember to love those even who are persecuting you and calling you blasphemy or blasphemers or however, because we know if we sit in the presence of the Lord, he unveils his secrets like Proverbs 25. The Lord hides things and then it's us to seek out the treasures that he goes and hides in the Bible. So stay in the presence of the Lord and know that you are loved and know that he is with you. And we are out of here soon. Bye-bye for now, brothers and sisters.